Welcome back to the channel, Crypto Trend Trader here. Today we're going to be taking a look at Bitcoin on the daily. But before we get started, I'd like to remind you this is not financial advice. I'm not your financial advisor. These markets are extremely volatile, so please do your own research and trade responsibly. So here we have our Coinbase chart. This is a Bitcoin daily, and we do have the TJD PSR with B pivots pulled up here, and that's our moving averages. That is our support and resistance, and then that's also our trend indicator in green and red here as well. So, and essentially what we're looking at right now is basically we've been playing out the same move. We had been basing off that 377 on the daily, and then we finally lost that, came down to the 528, shot back up above all the moving averages, and based out on top of the 200 simple. As soon as we lost that, we came down to a 200 exponential, and then, you know, we basically just fell off a cliff here, came back down, found temporary support at the 377 again, blew right through the 528. As soon as we found support close above, blew through that, finally based out down here in the middle of nowhere, came back up and tested the 377 and 10 as resistance. As soon as we got the close here and a powerful move up, we were able to test, the 528, we were able to test the 377 and the 21. We basically closed up here and immediately got rejected down. We have basically two more. Two more 4-hour candles until our weekly close, our monthly close. Two more 4-hour candles to our monthly close, and then tomorrow night will be our weekly close. So this is kind of a crazy situation here because, you know, we are essentially pinned between a key resistance and a key support in the middle of a consistent downtrend. And when we switch over here and check out like the weekly. Actually, let's go to the monthly first, since that's the most relevant and the longest time frame that's closing tonight. You'll see we're in a long downtrend. We were able to bust through that into the uptrend, and we're in currently not threatening the parabolic SAR. We did blast down, closed above the 10, blast down through it, and now if we don't get above at least 7,900, which is still possible but looks unlikely at this point in time, if we don't close above 7,900, we'll have lost the 10. On the monthly, which is obviously not good. We'll have essentially tested the 21 and found support though, but we would be between the 10 and the 21. If we do close the monthly tonight below 7,000, we're basically closing below the 21, and that could be the danger zone. But in my opinion, if you look at how this played out in the past, okay, as soon as we got pinned between the 10 and the 21, we essentially like never went above that point again on a close on a monthly scale. So that became our trading zone then for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 months. And then on the 6th month, we capitulated. So essentially, if we close right here, that could be an indication to the market that we're going to essentially go into this tight consolidation range in between, you know, basically, 7,000 and 8,000. And, you know, after that, what we would expect to happen is the same thing that's happened in the past, you know, until something tells us otherwise. And that would be a large capitulation candle, basically down to test the 50, 55, which is going to essentially come down here and put that trend in jeopardy on the monthly, because that's going to put us in that 4,600 range and, 50, 55 moving averages. So, and then I want to actually pull up the indicators real quick. And you'll see we did say on the monthly, we are potentially going to start threatening the jewel thief as, we're starting to lose our strengthening trend to the upside. We were in a strong trend. It started to level out a little bit. And now we are potentially going to level out completely. The purple is lagging, obviously. But now we have the knife is starting to stick down and is now below our blue line. So that is obviously not good. Same thing with TJD, TD, MACD. On the monthly, we now are getting ready to print another red. We were able to save from getting two in a row, but, you know, potentially next week. And two reds on the histogram is what I use, basically for a exit indicator if I am in a long trade. And then now we have on the weekly, let's look at just the parabolic SAR and moving averages. You'll see we came down here. We based on the 55, and then we pushed up and got rejected by the exponential 50. And now we are essentially between the two 50s, the 50 and 55. And we did manage to come back and save the 89. As long as we can stay above 72.40 tonight on this close for the monthly, you know, or actually the weekly would be Sunday rather. So as long as we can stay above this by Sunday, which who knows what's going to happen, because depending how that monthly candle closes is going to potentially, you know, dictate the longer term trend and, you know, how people react to it. So at this point in time, though, we are in a downtrend on the parabolic SAR. And if we do go to the downside, our next target again is going to be that 4,900 range, which is going to coincide with the 200 SMA and 200 EMA. So that's the exponential and the simple, which is where we based off of. Depending on which chart you're looking at on the Coinbase chart, they come into line together. But if you go to some of the other charts, we actually fell below the 200 and we're like in between the two of them. But the Coinbase chart doesn't go back as long of a time. So, but essentially still shows you the relevant information. So now here, depending on what happens here, our next target would be down here. We did get the exact move we said up to test the 50. And assuming we do not close above the 50, I don't see any reason right now to get bullish on this asset and assume that we would come all the way back up to the 8,500 range to test the 10 and 21, although the potential is always there. As you'll see, this is starting to look very similar to over here. We basically were getting ready to lose the 10 and 21, and then we got a push up above it, which got rejected, and then they crossed over negative. We came down and based in between the two 50s, the 50 and the 55, and then pushed up again, threatened the parabolic SAR, but failed to take it out. And that is one of the adjustments that's been made on this parabolic SAR, is essentially like how it's printing. You know, it's not going to allow the print to move ever. Once it's printed solid, and it is relevant to the time frame that you're on. So once that's printed here, it's not going to move based on the candle moving up or down. It takes it out regardless, and it does strengthen to the downside. So as soon as we fail to see that, you're going to see like continued sell-off. And now in this case, because the trend wasn't that long, the 90 has already been lost. If you lose the 55s, as we're here, the 90 was below the 50 and the 55. So this is a little bit different, but overall you'll see the same exact thing is happening. We're basically right here in the situation, essentially in this area. So we could still expect another test back up to threaten the trend in one of these two areas. I would expect probably something like this. So we could come again as high as like 9,500 if this market decided to get bullish. But I do think that's less likely at the time. Although I don't think we're necessarily just going to immediately sell off to the 4,900 range. But if you look at the risk reward, the likelihood of us testing up here, if it was 50-50, you know, obviously moving up to 9,700 versus moving down to 4,900. If we just close right here right now and we came up and threatened the parabolic SAR but didn't break it, that's 27% move. And then to the downside from where we're at right now, you are looking at a 35% move. So, and any of these key moving averages on longer time frames can act as a pivot in the market. So it's definitely, there's definitely potential for some long-term positions, you know, if you do have an inkling in one direction or the other for the direction of the trend. Now here on the shorter time frame, the daily, this is where you'll really see direct interaction with the improvements that we've made to this indicator. You'll see on your version now, you do have the 377 and 528 added in, which up to previously were only available to my team. You'll see we did come down here and base off them perfectly, and you'll see the interactions we're getting. I want to pull up the Jewel Thief and TJD TD MACD, and you'll see TD MACD rolled over green right here. Parabolic SAR give you the green in here, and of course TJD Jewel Thief nailed it again, giving the hard buy signal at the absolute bottom right here. Perfect buy signal, followed by this upward movement, and then we're going to go down one more time to the lower time frames. And keep in mind again, guys, that when we got this green, the blue right here, and then when we got the dark green right here with the dark blue right there, that was our death crosses playing out. And typically when the death cross plays out, you get a long extended continuation to the downside. This was our simple death cross over here. And then you'll see we basically got the death cross on the exponentials right here, came back up and defended it, and then got it again. And at that point in time, You know, with the exception of this little stab up right here, we never made it above the 200s again. So now that we're below the 200s and we've gotten our death cross, you know, other than a little flirt or two potentially back up into this region, you know, if we ever see price action closing on more than a daily time frame consistently over the 200s, I think it's safe to assume, you know, that this is a change in trend, change in behavior, and there is potential for continuation to the upside, and this was in fact a reversal. But until then, that's going to be a key indicator, being below the 200 moving average, exponential and simple, that we are in fact in a downtrend and will continue on in this downtrend until we see something else that changes that. And now we have formed our base down here for the trading range at 6,500 with the wick down here. And you'll see on the top side, our trading range is 9,000. So we do have a very nice trading range at the time, but we are pretty much, you know, right smack in the middle of it. So, you know, this area is probably one of the worst areas to be taking a position. I like to take positions at the bottom of a trading range or at the top of a trading range, assuming that we will continue on in that range. And I will have a position, you know, back in that direction from, if I'm going to take a long, I'd rather take it from the bottom. If I'm going to take a short, I'll take it from the top. And then if the trading range gets violated, I can exit that position and look for a position in the opposite direction, if that's so the case. So, but there we have it. Just wanted to do a short update and look at a couple different time frames. Everything, again, has been playing out perfectly. We said that if we consolidated long enough at the 377 and the 10 that we would likely test up, I'm sorry, the 528 and the 10 that we would likely test up to the 21 and 377. And we made the video there and said that, you know, if we saw a bullish continuation, that we could expect to move all the way up to like the 83-33 range, but that if we saw rejection, that we would likely come straight back down to the 377 and the 10, and then potentially, depending on where the close was for the monthly as well as the weekly, we could see continuation to the downside. Right now on the daily, this looks absolutely terrible. We basically did exactly what I said. We came back up. We failed. You know, we based on this area forever, came down and lost it and got the spring back to the upside, and then sold off consistently since then, blew straight through it and put in a new low, which is extremely bearish on the market. And then we came back up. We tested the exact level of the breakdown. We tested that level, which came back in into account with the 377 and the 21, and we immediately got rejected. And it's not just a little rejection. We didn't consolidate. We didn't get indecision. We got a strong rejection, which potentially could lead to a, you know, bearish engulfing candle at this point in time. And, you know, that's essentially signaling the market. But like we said in our previous videos and have been saying, you know, at this point in time for months, any moves to the upside are to be looked at as selling or shorting opportunities, and the true trades and the trending trades should be taken to the downside. So there we have it, guys. Crypto Trend Trader, the TJD PSAR with binary pivots, TJD Jewel Thief with the knife indicator, and our TJD TD MACD. I'm Crypto Trend Trader. This is your Bitcoin Daily Technical Analysis, and I'm signing off.